This morning, I wanted to share with you all a song that's meant a lot to me throughout the course of my life. And when I started doing this work towards becoming more and more conscious, this song came up for me again from my childhood, and I was like, wow, this really is a song about the journey from lower consciousness to higher consciousness, from living in a more unconscious state to a conscious state. So I'm going to sing it for you all. If you're enjoying the song, it is about 3 minutes. Like it or, thumbs up, give me hearts. If you're feeling like, okay, I've heard this song a gazillion times and, well, your voice is nice, let's move on to the show. So whatever you guys want to hear. If you love it, thumbs up. If not, just don't leave me mean comments, okay? All right. Look at this stuff. Isn't it neat? Wouldn't you think my collection's complete? Wouldn't you think I'm the girl who has everything? Look at this trove, treasures untold. How many wonders can one cavern hold? Looking around here, you think. Sure. She's got everything. I've got gadgets and gizmos aplenty. I've got who's its and what's its galore. You want thingamabobs? I got 20. But who cares? No big deal. I want to be where the people are. I wanna see 'em dancing, walking around on those, what do you call 'em? Oh, feet. Flipping your fins, you don't get too far. Legs are required for jumping, dancing, strolling along down the, what's that word? Street. Up where they walk, up where they run. Up where they stay all day in the sun, wandering free. Wish I could be part of that world. What would I give if I could live out of these waters? What would I pay to spend a day warm on the sand? Betcha on land. They understand, but they don't reprimand their daughters. Bright young women, sick of swimming, ready to stand and ready to know what the people know. Asking my questions and get some answers. What's a fire and why does it, what's the word? Burn. When's it my turn? Wouldn't I love to explore the shores up above, out of the sea? Wish I could be part of that Thank you all for listening. That's, of course, from The Little Mermaid. I really love that song. The beginning talks about those material possessions and we fill our life with all of this stuff. And really, it's not fulfilling. Really, we want something more. We want a deeper connection to each other and to life and to be living in a free and liberating way instead of stuck underwater. And it's interesting how she goes through that journey, finding little pieces of the land above, gadgets and gizmos. And she's like, okay, wow, these are signs that there's something more. And I think we all find that through our journey as well. So thank you for joining us today. I'm Jessica Disbrow. I'm a licensed social worker and registered psychotherapist here in the state of Colorado. I'm also the founder and primary therapist of Higher Consciousness Healing. We're an innovative mental health practice in Lakewood, Colorado, offering community building, free online education, and individual and group therapy. We also specialize in services for youth and millennials. If you want to learn out more, check out our website at www.higherconsciousnesshealing.org. Right now you're watching our live video blog, which we air every Saturday at 10 a.m. Mountain Time. We talk about different mental health topics from a spiritual and scientific perspective. So welcome. Last week we covered what do conscious relationships need? And one of the main things that they need, really vital, is a conscious person. Well, what does a conscious person look like? We've been talking about it in a lot of different ways, but I wanted to really flesh it out in this episode. The reason why I'm calling it Awakening to Higher Consciousness, though, is really what we're going to be doing today is talking about the differences between lower conscious or unconscious states of mind versus higher conscious or conscious states of mind from both a spiritual and scientific perspective. But the reason why I call it Awakening to Higher Consciousness, because I think it's really important. We want the prize at the end. You know, we want enlightenment and we're like, I want it now, you know, and you can have it now. But the point is that it's really about the journey there and all of the steps in between. And a lot of times we kind of want to spiritually bypass our challenges and the things that are happening in our life to just kind of like tune out and gain enlightenment and peace right now. And while that's great, we do have to look at the issues that are coming up in our lives and how we can deal with some of our unconsciousness. Because basically what's happening is life is a journey that moves from unconsciousness to states of higher consciousness. That journey is called life. And until life's over, we're continuing to make that journey. And some would even argue we continue to make that journey past this physical reality. And we're on this ride together, so that's the good news. But it's kind of like a roller coaster, and it goes up and down. However, over time, it is gradually going up. I watched a movie recently. Of course, I'm spacing the name of it right now, but they had a really nice mantra I want to share. He said, things always work out in the end. And if things aren't working out, it's not the end yet. So keep that in mind, because we all go through states of consciousness and unconsciousness, all of us. And so that's just really important framing for our conversation today. What does unconsciousness look like? And what does that lower level of consciousness look like from the brain perspective? As I've been talking about in the show, we had to do a lot of surviving in this physical reality, and that was really hard. So we developed a lot of fear-driven, competitive, really kind of not ideal things for collaboration and peace and love to survive, because we thought this is all it was and we're struggling to survive and we just can't blame ourselves for that, you know. However, we're reaching a new level of our evolution as humans. And so we're making this jump to a higher level of consciousness where we're no longer in that egoic state of mind, where we're mainly using the limbic system of our brain. And again, that's kind of the lower level of consciousness, the reptilian evolved parts of our brain that regulate fear and our trauma responses, all that anxiety. So that's kind of what unconsciousness looks like. But let's get more specific. The unconscious mind is really identified with thoughts and feelings. I've been there personally. We think our thoughts and feelings are us. I feel mad or angry. I am that anger. I am that emotion. Or other people who are constantly like stuck in their heads. I, for myself, had a lot of negative opinions about myself going on in my mind all the time. So we get identified with these. We think that they're us, but really they're just unconscious patterns playing out from earlier on in our life. So the unconscious mind is largely acting from those pre-programmed behaviors and patterns without a lot of self-awareness and just keep playing them out. To some degree, it's almost as if we lack a level of free will. We're not actually like acting, we're just replaying and, to some degree of awareness. In that state, we feel like life is happening to us and that we're kind of a victim of life, that we don't have a lot of control and we're lacking that personal responsibility of really taking control of our lives and ourselves in a new and empowered way. That's okay. We've all been there. Lastly, just to go back to that ego-driven state, it's really about fear, guilt, shame, sin, as A Course in Miracles would say. Those negative thought patterns, those negative emotions, that competitiveness, that needing to compare ourselves to others, being critical, being blaming, all of that stuff belongs in the unconscious mind category. And these are things that were just built into us that we all experience and that we all share as commonalities. So it's nothing to be shameful about. There's nothing to be worried about if you're like, wow, I do some of those things. It's totally okay. If you're watching this show, that means that your level of consciousness is so great that you're at least focusing and paying attention and wanting to work on these things. And that's the biggest tipping point between unconsciousness and consciousness is you become aware of your unconsciousness. So, what would the spiritual folks have to say about what unconsciousness looks like from their perspective? Well, it's someone who's not present and in their presence, someone who's not in union with spirit, the energy of themselves and those around. And the interconnectedness of everything. Someone who's at peace and is loving and kind and respectful. And that's a lot. That's a really big toll when we're talking about our pre-programmed brain who's gonna like run all of these programs a lot of times without us even knowing. And spiritual folks are like, well, just be with that. Just be with it. So I think let's fill in some gaps because I think there's some things that we can do to increase our consciousness. And when we hit that tipping point of saying, okay, I recognize my unconsciousness. I realize that I'm doing unconscious things. I'm not going to blame myself and get angry at myself. Instead, I'll recognize them with kindness and awareness and start working on myself. I've got some tips. Before I get into the tips, though, I just want to thoroughly define the conscious mind. It goes without saying that the conscious mind is no longer attached to those thoughts and feelings. They might see the thoughts and feelings, but they're no longer like, that's me, and I need to act on them and do whatever the program is. You're striving towards a successful present moment of calm and peace with yourself and things around you. And again, that's hard. And this is a progression that we go through throughout our life. Something I really want to drive home is that when you're in the conscious mind state, it doesn't mean that you're no longer never unconscious. As I said before, we kind of have peaks and lows and highs, depending on what's going on in our life and those challenges. And that's awesome. Respect the journey. Respect the journey. So you'll see these unconscious patterns happening less and less and less as the years go on. And yes, it's years. Though We can't all be like Eckhart Tolle and have like this massive switch where now we're super enlightened and we're trying to explain it to other people. And, everybody's learning their own lessons on their own time. I can't stress that enough. And so it's all about tuning into what we need to be focusing on for us and those lessons and who those teachers are at those different times. Because they're always changing. Different things are going to resonate with us. To go to the science bit, because I said I had some tips for reaching higher states of consciousness that a lot of spiritual people aren't really focusing on, and I just think it's super, super vital, and it's where the science piece comes in. Part of loving ourselves and being in the present moment also means really taking care of ourselves. And we can make a million excuses not to. But I want to say, like, I think this is the key to, I don't want to call it enlightenment because that makes it sound like unobtainable, but I feel like it's the key to getting our brains in a primed place so we can access those higher states of consciousness through spirit. And when we're not giving our bodies what our bodies need desperately, everything else gets thrown out of whack. And it's so easy to be operating on that lower state of consciousness from the brain level and not even be able to access those other parts of the brain that will help us get more in touch with that oneness and love and being. So, what do we need to do to take care of ourselves? Number one, sleep is the most important thing. 8 hours. You can't make up for it on the weekends. It's really that important. I'll share more information about that on my Facebook channel because there's a lot of research behind that. But just trust me, it's absolutely the most important priority you could possibly set for yourself. Second, diet, what you eat, making sure we're eating more foods that are better for that we evolved eating. I don't want to go on my soapbox about the paleo diet, but I do think for a lot of us, somewhere within that is a good place to be. Meats, fish, vegetables, fruits, nuts. If you want to do some grains, some rice and oats, things like that, find what works for you. That's important. And that's like a whole learning curve all on its own is diet. Really eating for our brain and body. Next one, you guessed it, exercise. Again, so important. Just a few times a week for 20 minutes will do you wonders. Dance around in your room for 20 minutes. Go for a jog. Anything to get your heart pumping, because what's happening is basically during the week, and for most of us in our normal lives, there's a lot to be stressed about and there's a lot to get anxious over. And our brain is being flooded with all of these chemicals and we're not doing anything with them. In years past, many years past, we would have been running from our threats, And so we would have been actually acting on that anxiety and that stress in a physical way, and we're not doing that. So by running and doing regular exercise just a couple times a week, really get your heart pumping though, we'll do wonders, wonders. That, I mean, if you can do those three things, along with being conscious of what those negative thought patterns are and detaching yourself from your thoughts and feelings, like you're gonna be like having an awesome life, having an awesome life. And this stuff is hard because it goes back to how hard it is to change those patterns. Please watch earlier episodes of this channel. I go into some of this stuff more in depth and just how important loving ourselves is to reaching that higher level of consciousness. And I just wanted to share a quote before we wrap up today from Eckhart Tolle. As I said, a lot of spiritual people believe this. The single most vital step on your journey toward enlightenment is this: Learn to disidentify with the mind. Every time you create a gap in your stream of consciousness, stream of mind, sorry, the light of your consciousness grows stronger. So it's really vital to start creating that gap, that higher consciousness that's watching your lower consciousness play out these patterns and say these negative things and kind of detach yourself from it. However, at the same time, taking care of our bodies is so important because that will make being present and mindful like a lot But it kind of comes hand in hand. You know, it's a little bit of a catch-22 here. Remember, it's not about being enlightened all the time. This is a journey that we're all on. This isn't like we get to beat up on ourselves because we're not super enlightened and like blissful in every moment. Why can't we achieve that? There must be something wrong with us. We all have our own journey. That's it, you know? We're all blessed with a different set of life circumstances, for better or worse, and we all have different steps that we need to make, and we heal on our own time in our own way, just like we learn different lessons at different times. All right, thank you so much for watching today. I really appreciate it. If you have any questions or comments, now would be a great time to ask them. So, next week, I'm going to be talking about being our authentic selves in relationships. The next few episodes, last episode included, is kind of in the conscious relationship realm. So, even though it doesn't really make sense that we're talking about a conscious person in this episode, it's absolutely super important because those relationships that we have with others absolutely positively start with the relationship we have with ourselves. And making sure that that's a good, genuine, like loving relationship. And then we can go and have those awesome relationships with others. And also be patient and kind with those who aren't learning the same lessons we are and need a little bit more kindness and patience. So, next week, being our authentic selves in relationships, I have a few announcements before I go, of course. We have the spiritual support group for millennials coming up again on December 14th. It'll be the second Thursday of every month. We're talking about the power of intentions, which I think is a great New Year's topic. So if you're interested, look up more information on Meetup. I'll leave that link in the description box above. Also, I have a group therapy program that's 12 weeks coming up in early 2018. Also, for millennials ages 18 to 30, we're going to be diving deep into really moving us from those states of unconsciousness or lower consciousness to states of higher consciousness, you know, along with all of the therapy and all of the education I have in the mental health realm, you know, coupled with some of those spiritual teachings. So, if this is like for you, definitely check it out on the web. And you can find more information there. I will leave that link in the description box as well. All right. I do see a very nice comment. Thank you for that. I don't see any other questions, so I'm going to wrap up for today. Thank you so much for watching, and I just want to take a minute to honor you and thank you for watching and dedicating this time for yourself. In your journey, it's so easy to bury our head in the sand and be like, it's not happening, you know, and we have to face our fears and empower ourselves. So, thank you for being here with us. All right, see you next week.